The plates below are shaking. The house and lands on earth are moving. I can see the fear on people's face, moving here and there in fear, without interest. Hopeless face and tearful eyes, praying to their God, thinking how to survive. Dear earthquake, why you come? Not only once, but again and again, with more and more aftershocks.
2005 के वाकये में मेरी जो एज थी ऑलमोस्ट 8 ईयर्स थी, उस दौरान जो है मैंने अपनी आँख का ट्रीटमेंट करवाना था, इस्लामाबाद जाना था, इसलिए मैं जो था स्कूल नहीं गया। मम्मा अपने रूम में सोई हुई थी, तो अचानक ही मैं बाहर बैठा हुआ अपने पेट्स के साथ खेल रहा था, तो अचानक ही जलजला हुआ। तो मुझे कुछ उस टाइम इतना कॉन्सेप्ट नहीं था इस बारे में, तो भाग के मैं अंदर अपने ड्राइंग रूम की तरफ गया, वहाँ पे सिमट कर बैठ गया खुद को बचाने के लिए। तो थोड़ी देर बाद जब देखा तो छत ऊपर थी मेरे, काफ़ी डरा। उस टाइम एक लाइटर था मेरे पास, लाइट वाला, तो उसके साथ मैं लाइट वगैरह लगाता था, तो उसी दिन घूम गया था। फिर अंधेरा ही अंधेरा था, 4 दिन पता ही नहीं लगे किस तरह गुजरे, क्या हुआ क्या नहीं। तो फिर तीसरे दिन जाके कहीं ड्रिल मशीन आई, उसने सुराख करना शुरू किए, तो वहाँ पे जो लाइट आई उस दिन दौरान, तो पत्थर वहाँ से हटा, तो एक बंदा अंदर आया, उसने मुझे आवाज़ें दी, मैंने आगे रिस्पांस वगैरह किया। फिर उसने मेरी नानी अम्मा को बुलाया, नानी अम्मा ने मुझे पहचाना, ये वो, मैंने उनको पहचाना, फिर उन्होंने मुझे इस तरह करके मलबा वगैरह टा के बाहर निकाल लिया।
हम बड़े मशहूर हैं हुकूमत पाकिस्तान के, आज तीसरे दिन उन्होंने बड़ी दिल खोल के आज़ाद कश्मीर के अवाम की खिदमत की है। आर्मी ने, बाकी तंजीमों ने, तमाम डॉक्टर वकला जो लोग भी थे, उन्होंने बड़ा कॉपरेट किया हमारे साथ।
The geophysical conditions, climatic extreme and high degree of exposure and vulnerability places Pakistan as a disaster-prone country. Pakistan is undergoing rapid changes, turning from a predominantly rural and agrarian to an industrial, service-based and urban economy. In last 2 decades, the country witnessed its most worst earthquake and floods, causing thousands of deaths. In October 2005, a major earthquake hit Pakistan's north, mostly affecting territory of Azad Kashmir. The depth of its epicenter was 15 kilometers northeast of Muzaffarabad. The official death toll was declared at a whopping 87,350, while at least 138,000 people were reported injured and over 3.5 million people left homeless. Similarly, in July 2010, Pakistan was hit by the worst floods, indeed the worst natural disaster in the history of Pakistan. 20 million people across an area of over 100,000 square kilometers were affected, causing 1.67 million houses and 2.2 million hectares of standing crops destroyed. Both the 2005 earthquake and the 2010 and 11 floods revealed the vulnerability of Pakistani society and economy to disasters. Damages and losses were massive, but could have been largely reduced if disaster risk reduction measures were properly incorporated.
We are a very high-risk country in the perspective of the effects of climate change. We have also a very active seismic zone we are located at. So, name a disaster, natural calamity that exists, it is there in Pakistan, and you have to work in a multiple directions to ensure the disaster risk reduction.
The 2005 earthquake illustrated the fact that disasters are not natural. They're closely related to human knowledge, skills and action or inaction. The 2005 earthquake gave a wake-up call to move from an emergency response paradigm to attention to prevention, mitigation and preparedness. Similarly, the floods demonstrated that much more energetic and multi-sectoral efforts are needed to tackle with increasing levels of exposure and vulnerability. According to the definition, DRR is the systematic development and application of policies, strategies and practices to minimize vulnerabilities, hazards and disaster impacts throughout a society in the broad context of sustainable development.
You need to have a very well thought out risk assessment, because then you can have a response to that. The second is definitely the capacity building. Capacity building of the community and capacity building of the government officials. And improvement of response at the lowest tier, at the district level.
Over the last two decades, the need of risk reduction strategies have been significantly felt by the government institutions to increase Pakistan's resilience to natural hazards and to ensure that development efforts do not increase vulnerability. Chapter 1. Understanding the roots of disasters. Hazards like floods, landslides, earthquakes all have the potential to cause deaths and injury and can cause damage or destroy property and environment. But effective measures can be taken to ensure that their destructive potential is reduced.
We can take the example of the tectonic plates, where our earth crust has certain formation. Our cities are lying over there. This is a hazard, but itself it is not something which can be a disaster. Only if we have something which matches the environment and it happens. For example, the buildings, if they are not built with appropriate safety code. The other hazard man-made can be a very simple thing like plastic bag use. When we use the plastic bag for every single thing, we never know that this can be such a hazard. Think about that, where they go, to the landfills, where they go, to the fields, where they go, to your streams. And whenever there is flooding season, the additional thing is when the lines are choked, there is more damage to the population on the banks of the nalas or streams.
Safe building techniques, evacuation measures, environmental management, which minimizes erosion, weatherproof storage facilities for grain. There are many ways to anticipate and prepare for such events and to minimize the hazards becoming a disaster.
When we talk about the magnitude of disaster, there are three things which are going to have major impact on the outcome of the disaster. One is hazard itself, like its magnitude and its length. The other is exposure. If people are exposed to that, say for example in flooding, if the river bank is there as a hazard and people are building on the banks, this is the exposure. The third thing would be vulnerability, people's ability to cope with that, and this would depend on their level of knowledge.
Risk is not just consequential. It is not just a consequence of the hazards that affect a particular place. It is also linked to social, economic, and other factors. Poor populations carry a disproportionate level of disaster risk.
Our biggest concern always remains to be the flood. We are having the recurring floods right after 2010 in the context of national calamity. If you go on to the statistics, that over around 72% of the disaster that the country faced from its independence had been in the hydrometeorological disasters. And then it is the earthquake, that around 10 to 15% we have been facing there. So for the floods, the mitigation measures, unfortunately, we have only two storage dams. So we have to play a very careful interplay of the water in these storage dams to mitigate the effects of floods. And alongside that, we also have a very elaborate system of flood protection works all over the country.
Chapter 2, Community Participation. Disasters hit the poorest communities, although the government's charities often respond with the emergency aid, but it really is important to engage the total community. After the 2005 earthquake, the international community responded immediately towards the appeal of relief efforts by the government, and a total of $5.4 billion in aid arrived from all over the world to assist Pakistan. Several donor agencies, government institutes, along with the Pakistani army, worked day and night in relief operations, but it was the local communities that were motivated not only in rehabilitation, but also to prevent any near future disaster.
Communities are basically the first responder of during any disaster. and they should know about the local hazards, and they should have the skills and knowledge about the local hazards, and they should know how to cope up with those disasters or hazards. Therefore, community-led programming, that is very important, and we should focus on that, like Pakistan Red Crescent, that is focusing on the community-based disaster reduction, and we are like implementing different programs, and we are strengthening the communities in disaster risk reduction, so that they can cope the disaster during the emergencies.
Disaster management system is a tiered system, in which we believe that the first response come at the local level. That is the district level. So we have the district disaster management authorities. And the head of the district disaster management authority is the head of the local government. We have identified the districts according to their vulnerability and exposure. And after we are done with our hazard mapping, we should be now going for a very focused, you know, community-based disaster risk management.
Involving community in DRR projects also requires a training in first aid. In recent years, much focus has been advocated towards the training and the education of the community.
Pakistan Red Crescent ne na sirf bahut se institutions mein, colleges mein aur universities mein logon ko train kiya, balki yahan pe humne takriban 152 ke kareeb master trainers ko jo hai wo train kiya, jinhone mukhtalif colleges mein, schoolon mein aur mukhtalif communities ke andar jaake logon ko train kiya. Iske alawa national level pe hamara wafaqul madaris jo hai uske sath ek charter of humanity sign hua, jiske तहत हमने तमाम मदारस के students को न सिर्फ first aid की trainings देनी है, basic first aid की, बल्कि हमारे जो उलमाए कराम हैं जिनका वाज जो है हर जुमे को हज़ारों नहीं बल्कि लाखों की तादाद में लोग सुनते हैं और उस पर हूबहू अमल भी करते हैं, उनकी बात की बहुत ज़्यादा अहमियत है. और उसके साथ साथ जो स्कूल टीचर्स हैं उनको हमने फोकस किया.
The active commitment and leadership within a local community is important for the implementation of any successful local disaster risk reduction measure.
If you compare 2005 and 2016, there is a great difference between 2005 and 2016 about earthquake and the disasters management, because most of the NGOs worked here for a long period of time about earthquake and disaster management, and they prepared the people for the earthquake and disaster management.
Chapter 3, Social Inclusion. Disasters' impact varies on different members of communities, especially the marginalized population, which includes women, children, elderly and disabled ones. The nature and extent of their exposure and vulnerability is different for women, men, girls and boys because of their different roles, responsibilities, access to resources, domestic and traditional law, and legal and cultural issues. According to government officials, in 2005 earthquake, around 19,000 children died during the earthquake due to the collapse of school buildings in various parts of Kashmir.
हमे इस चीज के बारे में पहले ये नहीं पता चल सका कि ये जलजला है या क़यामत आ रही है. जलजले में इतनी तबाही हुई है कि बिलखुसूस हमारी तमाम स्कूल्स की जितनी बिल्डिंग्स थी, कोई बिल्डिंग जो है वो स्कूल की बच नहीं सकी.
During a disaster, women may be less able to evacuate to a safe place following a hazard because they are pregnant or caring for children and less mobile dependents. Their exposure and that of their dependents may be much greater than that of others who are able to leave high-risk areas.
Mandate of the UN Women is to train women, and for this we have established as in SDMA the Gender and Child Cell and Gender Task Force, in which we address actually those organizations who are working towards the women, and they are supporting women in DRR and making them resilient for God forbid for any disaster or for any calamity.
Children make up more than half the population in vulnerable communities, urban neighborhoods and countries. Involving them in its design and implementation increases the likelihood of a resilience building program or policy being responsive to their needs. As children interact with other children and adults, if they are well informed and supported, they can be effective channels of information, role models and agents of change.
The education is a devolved subject, you know, in Pakistan, so it has to be at the provincial level. That we need to include not only the disasters but also the climate change, because it's a reality now. So climate change and the disaster management, in which disaster risk reduction is an integral part, has to be taught as a subject.
School children should be equipped with the knowledge to minimize the impact of disaster. There exists immense potential in the form of Boy Scouts and Girls Guides. However, there's a need of integration of DRR and safety aspects into the training and mentoring packages for Boy Scouts and Girls Guides. All people living with disabilities have capacities for activities that are of benefit to them and others. Unfortunately, women, men, and children with disabilities are often excluded from aspects of a community's daily life because of a lack of awareness or assumptions made by other members of that community.
Disabled logon ko is hawale se trained kiya jaye ki wo apne aap ko manage kar sake ki koi bhi disaster ho to wo apne aap ko kis tarah save kar sakte hain kyunki jab tak usko sikhaya nahi jayega bataya nahi jayega to uske liye ye cheez कोई माना नहीं रखती कि कोई डिजास्टर आया है तो वो अपने आप को कैसे सेव करे कैसे ना करे.
In general, older age can result in decreased mobility and muscle strength. These physical limitations may prevent older people from preparing for hazards. Physical limitations may also prevent older people from adopting risk reduction and adaptation measures that require manual labor. Nevertheless, older people's knowledge of the community's history, layout and demographics can be an asset to any project and community or neighborhood, and they may be well placed to identify other vulnerable people.
Ek school tha Rizwan school, wahan se wo pure aa gaye the. Hum log kisi na kisi tarike se yahan pahunche, lekin hamare samne bacche cheete rahe, bachao 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 ki awaazein aati rahi, khamosh hoti rahi aur hum koi madad nahi kar sake. Hamare paas koi cheez nahi thi aur darjanon ke hisab se wo bacche आखिर वहाँ ही वो उसमें वो शहीद हो गए. और इसी तरीके से बुज़ुर्गों की यहाँ तक सूरत हाल थी, उनकी भी यही हालत थी और बहुत सारे लोग बचाए जा सकते थे अगर ये ट्रेनिंग तो होती. तो मैं समझता हूँ कि कम अज़ कम भी हम अगर ज़्यादा नहीं तो ये 30-35% लोग जो थे ना, ये उस वक्त बचाए जा सकते थे.
चैप्टर 4, डेवलपिंग स्ट्रेटेजिक पार्टनरशिप. On numerous occasions, local people and organizations are the main actors in disaster risk reduction and disaster response. When a disaster strikes, immediate response, like searching, rescuing and caring for injured, traumatized and homeless, is often carried out by family members, friends and neighbors and grassroots organizations. But local communities often lack sufficient knowledge about disaster risks and vulnerabilities of their communities, as well as appropriate disaster risk reduction measures. Partners like INGOs, NGOs, government-partnered organizations can help local communities understand them in order to better plan and manage local disaster risks.
तो इसमें जब तबाही आई तो फौरन जो काम किया वो तो आर्मी ने रेस्क्यू किया, लोगों को जो लोकल कम्युनिटी को मोबिलाइज करते हुए लोगों को मलबे के नीचे से निकाला, फिर उनकी तदफीन की. उसके बाद फिर जब इंटरनेशनल कम्युनिटी ने जो है बहुत ज़्यादा तावन किया इसमें, स्पेशली डिफर्ड ने, वर्ल्ड बैंक ने, इस्लामिक डेवलपमेंट बैंक ने, यूएसएड ने इन लोगों को ट्रेनिंग्स दी थ्रू लोकल एनजीओज, इंटरनेशनल एनजीओज, ताकि ये लोग अपने जो लोगों का जो दुख है उसको बुला सकें और अपनी रिहैबिलिटेशन की तरफ जाएँ.
A number of NGOs in Pakistan have been very active in advocating for better DRR policies and practices at the national level. Many of them have developed their programs and projects to educate local communities about the potential impact of natural hazards and assist them in identifying possible ways to minimize their adverse consequences through collective and preventive action.
We are engaged, very actively engaged with UNDP, we are engaged with the WFP, UNICEF, UN Women, in different interventions. And also alongside that, we're now trying to engage the private sector to develop these partnerships for all the facets of disaster management.
The relationship between local partners and INGOs should be established based on strategic vision, mission and interests of both sides, with sufficient and detailed capacity building programs to bridge the gaps between the two partners' views, plans and strategies. Field experience shows that this type of partnership creates and fosters local partners and communities' feelings of ownership of development projects, which in turn helps to facilitate sustainability projects and development interventions.
We are working closely with the State Disaster Management Authority and with their DDMS, which are obviously the deputy commissioners in the districts. And we have developed a very robust program for them through the Gender and Child Cell, which is established in SDMA. And I believe if at one point in time, if UN Women leaves and is not supporting that specific component, then government has the capability and capacity to take it forward.
While it is important to establish a long-term partnership, it is of equal importance to remember that the goal of such an endeavour is sustainable outcome, not dependency upon the international community. Chapter 5. Resilient Livelihoods. Disasters have adversely affected the lives and livelihoods of millions over the past years, with particular deleterious consequences for the poor and politically marginalised. The impacts of the catastrophic earthquake in October 2005 and the floods in July 2010 show how disaster risk and poverty are closely interlinked.
जल्जले से पहले यहाँ पर अक्सरियत में कच्चे मकान बनते होते थे, वो कच्चे मकान इस तरह होते थे कि नीचे से एक लकड़ खड़ी की, उसके ऊपर एक लकड़ डाली, उसके ऊपर जो है छोटी छोटी लकड़ी डालकर मिट्टी डाल दी, बिल्कुल नापायदार किस्म की वो कंस्ट्रक्शन थी, जिसकी वजह से हमारा बहुत ज़्यादा जो है वो नुकसान हुआ कि वो पहले ही झटके में था, समझ सारे के सारे मकान जो है वो डिमालिश हो गए जी। तो अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह अब उसके बाद बहुत सारे NGOs आई, बहुत सारे इंजीनियर्स आए, बहुत सारे जो है हुकूमती इदारे आए, उन्होंने हमारे जो है ना वो कंस्ट्रक्शन के हवाले से बहुत ज़्यादा अवेयरनेस दी, जिसका आप जो है ना वो यहाँ पर देख सकते हैं इधर उधर मकान बने हुए, कि उन्होंने हमें स्टील का फिक्सन हमें बताई, उसकी बेसिक कंस्ट्रक्शन हमें बताई और किस तरह जो है ना इसको मजबूत किया जा सकता है। बेशक कच्चे ही मकान बनाएं, लेकिन उनकी कंस्ट्रक्शन इस अंदाज से करें कि कम अज़ कम जल्जले का पहला झटका वो बर्दाश्त कर सकें, लोग जो है वो बाहर चले जाएँ। आज से मैं समझता हूँ 6 महीने पहले कम अज़ कम जो है ना वो 7 का वो जल्जला यहाँ पर फिर भी आया, अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह उसका ड्यूरेशन इतना ज़्यादा नहीं था, लेकिन उसने कोई हमारा इतना बड़ा नुकसान हो नहीं किया, तो उससे हमें अंदाज़ा हुआ कि हमें किस काफ़ी हद तक जो है वो कामयाब हो गए हैं।
The resilient livelihood basically should have 4 components which are really important. Foremost is legislation. Legislation is through parliament, and obviously we cannot take any step without legislation. Second thing is use of local resources, because we are so much dependent on the things which, where we are living and what already is there. Third thing is we have to integrate all the institutions which are working for that, and integration is needed at all levels of preparedness. And fourth thing is, which is a bit futuristic approach, use of technology and best practices. We have seen in 2005 earthquake that our schools were destroyed first, and our kids were out of school for such a long time. We have to invest in our future. If e-schools, we get the opportunity to develop the e-schools, we are securing our future. We are not leaving our kids without any skills. And for that very moment, there is another thing which we can do. Our society is agri-society. Think about that. If the soil is destroyed, this happened in 2005 that the land was destabilized. If we train the susceptible communities for more than one crafts, I think we can cope the livelihood better.
Chapter 6, Sustainability. Research shows that investing in disaster risk reduction, DRR, prior to disaster saves lives, reduces losses, and is far more cost-effective than funding response after disasters. Successful DRR not only tackles current problems, but also needs to take into account long-term sustainability and environmental protection concerns to reduce future risk.
For effective impact of DRR, basically there should be 4 things to be followed. The very important thing is collaborative effort by all the stakeholders for the economic uplift. Collaborative effort by stakeholder means right from the community to the government to all the partners. About educating DRR, we can avail different institutions in local community, right from including the syllabus in the institution, educational institutions, using all other institutions including masjid, because people come to masjid and listen to imam every Friday more than anybody else. That can be a wonderful platform to educate the people. And the other thing is, in Pakistan we have the primary health system which is focused on preventions as well, and which can include this DRRs as well. 10 defined points of primary health care in Pakistan, only two are related to health provision. Rest eight are related to the prevention, and DRR can be included in that, embedded in that very effectively. There should be a building code. And fourth thing is that community, unfortunately, is the first responder as well, being the victim and being the responder. It's a difficult thing, but we can train them how to approach to the rescue, because in the concrete jungle, rescuing the people is a difficult task unless we train the people to have the safe approaches for themselves as well, because sometimes saving someone else costs your own life. So people's training for the rescue and first aid, that would be the most important thing for us.
DRR has strong linkages with political will, so that effective policies and strategies are shaped. It calls for a serious effort by the decision makers and the authorities, and the process falls in the realms of governance.
The sustainability starts, and it is very much doable, that if there is an ownership of it, and it is done through a thread of a very well-conceived, chartered-out plan. What we are looking at is that, like in Pakistan, we have carried out a macro level risk assessment at the district level. So we are now going for a micro level risk assessment right up to the UN Council level. And based on that risk assessment, when we carry on and undertake all the projects, alongside that, I must tell you that mainstreaming of disaster risk reduction in all the development projects has been pursued by us. And in all the development projects which undertake, there's a checklist which is that it has to be DRR compliant. So this by itself, that while you ensure it in the planning and execution part of it, so it's going to have that sustainability.
Much has been done, much more is required. And even today, droughts, floods, landslides, earthquakes still terrorize our country. It is necessary to develop an understanding to these disasters, but also to be prepared to save our loved ones.